Yo, 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 what is good, world? What is good? You are now attuned in to Hip Hop and Politics with Queen Delilah, and we are independent people. Yes! First ever show where we are independent. We are not on Clayton State Internet Radio anymore, but shout out to Clayton State Internet Radio because I love them. They have definitely promoted everything I've ever tried to do, anything and everything. And I mean, thank you. But the queen has moved on to more independent status. But all shouts out to my school. I love my school. We're still rocking hard. But yo, we have got a lady show today. Yo, I got politics. I got news. I got gossip. I got that ratchetness. And I got that professionalism that everybody likes. So let's jump into it. Yo, the Houston storm was crazy. Pray for Houston. It's they're flooding. The hurricane was terrible. They're still talking about more moisture, more flooding, more inches of rain and water coming to the Gulf. So it's real bad. If you know anybody out in Houston, please tell them that they can also reach out to FEMA. They can reach out to any type of resource that they know. Everybody is evacuating to the Targets. So if you know them, please tell them the Targets is giving the flood victims housing. They're giving them food and shelter. So please, 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 please give that information to anybody in Houston. Anybody got family in Houston. And the National Weather Society, along with NPR.org, is saying that Hurricane Harvey is not going strong, but it has, you know, given Texas some serious damage. It started out as it has weakened to a tropical storm, so the situation in Houston is growing more urgent as rain is still falling on Houston. Now, it's a major disaster, and it dropped waves as heavy on the city. It's not giving me inches yet, but it is saying that the Red Cross shelter in North Downtown of Houston is still helping people and giving housing and any type of emergency material and evacuations anybody need. It's really, really sad, yo. I'm from Miami. So let me tell you, while everybody's enjoying your summer, our summer's always cut short because of hurricanes. I mean, yo, like, seriously. No, it really is. Like, it's pretty dang gone bad. And let me tell you, the worst thing is that year, anybody that has the name of the hurricane is, like, taunted all through, like, school. So it's like, yo, Hurricane Harvey, oh, Lord. And hold on, pause real quick. I mean, if they gonna do Harvey, every time I think of Hurricane Harvey, I'm thinking about Steve Harvey. That's like so wild. Like, hold on, wait, y'all sure y'all got that name right? Is that what the name said on a card? Or y'all got that card information wrong? Is this a joke? But again, I know it's not. I know. Bad joke, huh?
Yuck.
listen. Don't mess with my sound effect. Okay, I like my sound effect. But anyway, moving along into politics. We may not be having a Mr. Donald Trump anymore. I mean, seriously, who's ready for Trump's impeachment? Trump's impeachment is real serious. It's actually the most popular solution that's going on in the politics right now. And this report is given to you by crooksandliars.com. Ooh, I love this website. It's so gritty. It says Trump's impeachment is most popular solution among Americans. And this is by a poll. Mr. Tom O'Connor, who is the editor for this paper, is saying that most people in a new survey said the best response to Trump's action while president is to impeach him or otherwise just remove him from office. Now, the Harvard University Center for American Political Studies and research marketing firm Harris Insights and Analytics this week published the results of their monthly national poll in which they were given choices for how to deal with the president. 43% said that he should be impeached or otherwise removed from office, while 42% said nothing should be done, and only 12% said he should be censured by Congress. So I don't know. Yo, it's going bad. It's going down. Amid multiple investigations into whether Trump's campaign colluded with Russia, a series of high-level administration dismissals, and recent polarizing remarks on the violence in Charlottesville, Virginia, talk of removing the president has increased. I mean, hold on, pause. If you don't know what the hecky has been going on in the world, okay? This man that we have as our president, after so many changes and moves and milestones in our American government, American history, and let's just say, I'm just going to go ahead and call it out, in racism, period, there has been strides. And I'm not going to say strides. I'll say there have been evolutions of how to hide the racism. You dig? But oh no, not our Mr. Trump. He just blatantly said it. And pause. Back up a little bit more. So, Charlottesville, Virginia, they had their protest, they had their protest rally, okay, where neo-Nazis actually attacked Black Lives Matter rally members that were actually opposing the rally, okay? So, Trump, instead of being a good president like he's a should have, he actually made some beep beeps. Okay, I know. Tell me about it. Yay. Thank you. Yeah. I know. Clap. Yay. Woo. Yay. Woo. Thank you. Thank you. I'll be here till Sunday. All right. Now listen. Okay. He sat there and made some remarks. We're not even going to try and go over the remarks because if you break them down, I ain't going to lie. They just stupid as hell. Period. So, what's going on is that he made some stupid remarks, and what he was saying was that the neo-Nazis were bad for doing what they did, but the opposers, which are Black Lives Matter, were bad for doing what they did. It was just ridiculous. And if anybody knows, hello, it is in our Constitution that we can assemble, we can protest, we have our freedom of speech, our freedom to bear arms, and our freedom to assembly. Yes, look it up in your Constitution, people. It is part of the Bill of Rights. Woo. And if you didn't know, the Bill of Rights is the first 10 bills in our Constitution. Huh? The most important. It goes to our human rights. So, back to crooksandliars.com. Amid multiple investigations into whether Trump's campaign did allude with Russia, there's a high-level administration dismissals and recent polarizing remarks on the violence of Charlottesville, Virginia. Talk of removing the president has increased, and some politicians have already begun the process or declared their intentions to do so of the impeachment. Last time I checked, they were missing 6 votes to impeach the president. And if nobody knows what impeaching means, listen, don't just put in your head, oh snap, impeachment means that fool finna be sitting up out of office. Oh snap, snap, he ain't finna be there no more. No, brother, hold on. Let's just, you know, slow our roll down. I mean, even if it's the queen, hold on, queen. Pump your brakes. Let me tell you what impeachment means, okay? The true definition, all right? It's to call into question the integrity or validity of a practice. So, let me tell you the separations, okay? In the U.S., it means to charge the holder of a public office with misconduct, okay? But in Britain, it is the charge with treason or another crime against the state. Let me just break this down a little bit more. So, let's back it up a little bit, all right? Now, when we're talking about impeachment with our presidents, you know what I'm saying? He can get impeached, but he just would not have any powers. He could not use his executive powers. And right now he's using his executive powers to do a lot of the things that is on his personal agenda and is not on the American people's agenda. One of the things is that he has stated if Congress does not approve the money for his wall, he's going to do a government shutdown. And if nobody remembers about the government shutdown, government things do get shut down. The first thing would be like the post office, like our federal funded schools. Yeah, I'm sorry, but that's a hell of a lot. Because if you think about it, public schools are still federally funded and state and local ran. So it ends up being where schools, jobs, I mean, everything gets shut down. So, I mean, think about it. If your mama working for the post office, honey, she ain't get paid Friday. And if you tricking on that dude, from the post office, baby, your check ain't getting cut this Friday. I'm just saying, government shutdown ain't the best. It's not cool. But just think about it. Obama made government shutdown for his healthcare bill. So many millions of Americans can be covered by healthcare. He made his bill so other people can benefit from it. Trump is making his bill because the brother got a little racism in him. I mean, hold on. Let's pause real quick. Immigration is a big problem in our country, okay? But you also got to look at the other facts of immigration. Immigration is very, very beneficial. Immigration, the problems, the cons of immigration is when you talk about how much funding that the government puts into things like, the borders and to protect the state lines, how much money these states, that was just federal funding, how much money the states put into the programs for the immigrants to go to school, get certain citizens, working permits or whatnot. Now, the pros to immigration, look at our agriculture. Look at how our nation is evolving into diversity. I mean, my kids are constantly, trying to mimic Spanish because they want to learn it. Look at how our businesses are thriving with diversity. Look how the American people, which is a diverse people, are beginning to integrate business. And I mean, really, golly, we're just dope. I mean, think about it. We're America people. We were never just one type of people. If you think about all these business, small business, everything functions together. So more states can receive grant funding and so forth and so on because their population is growing. More people are involved in voting. So, I mean, again, government shutdown, big no-no, but that's what he plans on doing. But I mean, if we was to impeach him, I mean, how many people are with me? Put your hands together. Come on. Give me some. Hello. That's all I needed, people. That's all I needed. Yeah. So, the guy's only been in office 8 months. We're already getting into a pre-civil war because if you haven't been hearing, police have become very aggressive and hostile. Racism is all over the place with the political campaigns and the political remarks that Trump is making in his position of power. So, besides the pre-civil war, God knows we're about to go to war with North Korea. Hold on. Let's take a break. I'm going to let you know about the war with North Korea going on, but I'm going to let it be on the next segment because, baby, these 2 minutes that I got left, honey, I cannot let you in on this tea in 2 minutes. So, hold on. We'll be right back with Hip Hop and Politics with Queen Delilah. Stay tuned. And just if you want to know the artist I was playing in the beginning of my show, that is Fred E.T. Look him up. Fred, FRED.T. He's dope. He's funky. He's out of McDonough, Georgia, Clayton County, Georgia, Henry County, Georgia. I believe, yeah, Henry County. Super dope. Take a listen. One of my favorite songs, which is Heaven Sent. Yeah, Heaven Sent. Let's go. Hip Hop Politics. Stay tuned.
Just a glimpse, you know what I'm saying? Just a glimpse of what, you know, the better life will be. Or like the afterlife.
On the much higher note, I'm just glad to be down. On the much higher note, I'm just glad to be down. On the much higher note, I'm just glad to be down. On the much higher note, I'm just glad to be down.
Get it. Freak out, hey, yeah. Hey, What you doing? What's up with the aspiration that you're pursuing? Run into a few dents up in the blueprints, give you a few hints of what this life could be. ET, earn at least 100 mil in about 4, 5, 6 years. And I can just let my opulence stretch for many eons. Give or take all year, on and on like a Badu song. Feel like I do no wrong. Smell the coffee in the road.